Gerbeagly!
Hey there, guys and gals, it's Gerbeagly with another episode of Gaming with Gerbeagly, and I'm once again playing the game Katawa Shoujo. Now, my buddy Joey, who is a native Japanese speaker, corrected me the other day, and I still don't remember what the correction was because I'm a terrible student. But anyway, last episode, basically what happened was Emmy broke up with Hisao, and it was devastating, and he's really confused. He has no idea what to do. It might not be a true breakup. It could just be him overthinking things, and it could just be sort of like a quick break that they're on. But regardless of whatever it is, it's pretty funky. It's her pushing him away and forcing distance between them, which isn't the best thing ever for a relationship. But we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna hopefully let Hisao go for a run on the track and feel a lot better, let off some stress. That's what he's decided to do. The morning is cool and clear, if a bit humid. Summer's making itself known, it seems. Emmy's already stretching out when I arrive and greets me with a smile and a wave.
Hey, Hisao.
The sight of her so chipper is like a kick in the nuts. How can she be so happy after yesterday? I give a half wave and am surprised to receive a hug.
Hey, about last night.
Here it comes.
I wanted to say thanks. I actually managed to get some sleep for the first time in a while, and I think it's because of our talk. So, thanks.
How could she sleep better after our chat? Is it because, like, she knows she put that emotional distance there and got, you know, the weight off her chest to not be stressed out and pressured by having a boyfriend? I wonder. That's really weird that she would just do that. That's kind of, you know, that is really a kick in the nuts. She basically told me that she wouldn't get any closer to me. And that let her sleep well? Excuse me, but what the hell? Emmy either doesn't notice my bafflement or chooses not to notice. No telling with her anymore. Oh, no problem. Glad it helped. The venom that threatens to drip into my voice is controlled for now, but I think I'd better start running now before I do anything stupid. Emmy seems equally willing to get started, and before long we're darting around the track. I can tell she feels more relaxed. Her running has gone back to the more graceful movements I remember from when I first watched her. It's a stark contrast to the almost brutal way she's been hurling herself around the track these past few days. Our talk really does seem to have helped her. There's nothing worse than someone telling you something that affects you a ridiculous amount and acting like it's nothing, like it just rolls off their shoulders, or they're even feeling better because of something that they did that kind of crushed your spirits. That's a tough thing to deal with, and there's so many different ways to go about it depending on the circumstance, but this one is pretty brutal. I feel real bad for Hisao right now. A pity it couldn't help me. I get into the rhythm of the running, thinking back to when I couldn't afford thinking about anything else but keeping my breathing steady and legs moving. Guess those days are gone. At least for the first couple of laps. Oh man. Annoyed at the lack of success I'm having with clearing my head, I increase the pace. Oh man, I knew this was gonna happen. He's gonna like hurt himself. He's gonna have a heart attack again. There's the burning sensation in my legs, the breath coming ragged in my chest, and the pounding of my heart. Which I still need to be careful about. But it does seem to have gotten stronger. I can feel it pumping blood through my veins. The sound thrums in my ears, but instead of being panicked as I was that day in the snow, I'm instead filled with elation. Yes, it's working. My heart, that fatal flaw that landed me here, has improved. I'm able to keep going now, and maybe one day, I'll be able to stop worrying as much. Oh man, like, I hope that he's not, like, the takeaway thing is that I'm healthier as a human being now, and Emmy feels better about herself, so let's go our separate ways. That would be terrible. I'd hate that ending. That would be a kick in my nuts. I would be very, because I'm so invested in these characters at this point, I can't just see them split up like that. I gotta do something to stop them. Right now, it doesn't matter that I have no idea what to do about Emmy and me. All that matters is that my arms and legs continue to pump in concert with one another. Nothing else. As I hit the final stretch, I remind myself that running really does help, though not as much as I'd hoped. I do feel better, and as I walk a few laps to cool down, I begin to remember last night in a slightly less emotional manner. Oh, did you exaggerate things, Hisao? Emmy wants me to stay distant from her. Excuse me, guys, I got the burpees already. God dang it, you guys always give me these burpees. Shame on you. I can't bring myself to do so. There's got to be a way around this. Some kind of middle ground I can reach. Not sure what that middle ground is, though. Damn, I was almost feeling optimistic.
Nice run, Hassel. You've really improved.
Nice run. That's all I can hope for now, isn't it? Congratulations, Hassel. You're pathetic. I gotta change my attitude. Well, you know, I am pretty awesome. And yet, I just keep saying things that I don't mean. Any second now, I'll be as good at hiding my problems as Emmy is.
I like to think so.
Why does she do this to me? Say something like that with such real affection in her voice that it makes my heart leap. She doesn't mean it. She can't. I must be doing a worse job than I thought because Emmy peers closely at me.
Hey, you feeling okay? Maybe we should go to the nurse, huh?
Yeah, I'd hate to keel over on you. Emmy looks a little shocked at my bitter tone.
Don't say things like that. You've already done it once before, you know?
Why does she act so affectionate? She doesn't really care. I thought you made that clear. But despite all of that, I find myself apologizing, even though I shouldn't have to. Even though she's probably just putting on an act. Sorry. Come on, let's see the nurse. I can't get myself to calm down the whole time. Every time it feels like I've gotten over what happened last night, Emmy does something or says something that shows affection, and I'm back to the beginning. The image of her ending that conversation haunts me. It was like the final twist in the knife that left me feeling bereft of any hope that Emmy and I could be more than what we are. And what are we at this point? Little more than friends who happen to fuck. Whoa, Hassel is really angry if he's talking like that. And really, it's not like I don't enjoy the time I spend with her. Said so the other day myself. I very nearly didn't even bring anything up with her. Was just gonna hop on in there and let it ride, wasn't I? Can't do that either, though, man. You can't hide your feelings from a person who hides their feelings because it's like, you know, we've been saying this whole time, like, she needs to open up, but he also needs to find that perfect middle ground where he's not forcing her, she feels comfortable, he's giving her enough space so that she can just breathe and feel comfortable and open herself up like that. But, man, right now, it's like, really, I totally hear him on feeling, like, kind of bitter about this, letting her sort of walk all over him emotionally and call all the shots. There needs to be some kind of compromise. But anyway, sorry about the rambling. With this running through my head, I find myself in the middle of the nurse's office, still brooding as he checks out Emmy. Emmy comes bounding out of the door, gives me a kiss, and darts off to shower, I assume. Meanwhile, the nurse beckons me into his office to give me the ritual once over. Gives him a kiss. Maybe in her mind, like her saying, hey, I need a little bit of space was just for that conversation. Maybe that was just for the night, or maybe she even changed her mind overnight and just doesn't know how to express it and say sorry to Hassel, and he's like freaking out over nothing, technically. Oh man, this is confusing to me too. It's like I'm part of this relationship. Any problems today? Nah, I even pushed it a little harder today than I have in the past, and I seemed able to handle it. That's uncharacteristically risky coming from you, Hassel. You've been hanging out with Emmy too much. She's rubbed off on you, and not necessarily in a good way. At the mention of Emmy's name, I can't help but frown unhappily in spite of my efforts at control. Well now, this is new, don't you think? Last I checked, your usual response to Emmy's name was a grin, not a frown. What exactly happened between you two? Because Emmy doesn't seem to be in on it, whatever it is. She looked more relaxed than I've seen her in weeks, which is unusual for this time of the year. What do you mean by that? Oh, it's totally around the time of the accident. It's around the time that she lost her dad, I bet. By what? For this time of year, I keep trying to find out what's been bothering her, but she clams up as soon as I broach the subject. Then last night she said, let me guess, she won't tell you because she says she can't trust you. And now you're crushed because you thought that the two of you was so much more than she seems to think, right? More or less. How the heck did you know? Hassel, I'm the nurse. It's my job to know these things. Plus, I've known Emmy for long enough to know that she'd try to do something like this. It's just like her. He says this in sort of half-affectionate, half-frustrated tone that would seem more appropriate if he had a cigarette dangling from his lips. As it is, he seems willing to do, to make do with a pen. Man, I'm sorry I'm having so much trouble reading tonight, guys. Oh no, another choice! I gotta save. I always gotta save. I gotta make more save files. Yes, save files all the time, because I don't wanna... I don't wanna mess up, we're so late in the game! Look, you mind if I give you some advice? No, this is my problem, sure, why not? Every time we've taken advice from someone, it's actually worked out really well for us, and the nurse really does seem to know Emmy the most. We don't want to push away any allies at this point, so I think we're going to go ahead and choose yes. What was it Mudo said yesterday? If you can't observe the thing, then observe what's around it? Worth a shot. There we go, yeah, Mudo like gave us the best advice of all time. The nurse knows Emmy better than I do, I'll wager. Sure, I'm open to suggestions. Honestly, I'm kind of lost. I've got no idea how to deal with this. I never would have guessed. He grins while he says this. I think he's kidding. Look, here's the deal. Emmy is stubborn. You should know that by now, and if you don't, then you're pretty unobservant. But I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt here. I'm so grateful. Anyway, if she's decided that she doesn't want to talk about what happened, then she's not going to talk about what's happened. Has she said anything about what's been bothering her? Even a hint? Well, she did say she's been having nightmares about the accident. Really? You're making progress then. That's good. Well, I guess I can fill you in on this without violating my strict non-inference policy when it comes to Emmy making stupid decisions. The anniversary of her accident is coming up soon. She gets depressed around this time because it was a pretty traumatic event considering what she lost. That's the other thing, she acted like she lost more than just her legs. What happened? I could have sworn that they already made like a really obvious hint that she lost her dad in the accident too. Like, what is Sasao's problem? That's a really important thing to know about your girlfriend. Whoa. Nope, not going there. You'll have to ask someone else about that because that's a whole can of worms I'm not about to open. If Emmy wants you to know, she'll tell you in her own time. You've just got to be patient, that's all. Why are you even helping me with all this? Because you're good for her. She trusts you, even if you don't think she does. And you've got the best chance out of anyone at the school right now to help her through this time of year. She won't accept my help, but she might accept yours if you don't screw it up. So, don't screw it up, got it? I open my mouth to respond, but a knocking sound at the door interrupts me.
Hey, you guys still in there?
Just a moment, Emmy. Give us a second to get our pants back on. The door bursts open and Emmy glares knives at the nurse.
Asshole.
Didn't mean to get your hopes up. Hey, can we leave me out of this? Anyway, what's up, Emmy? Forget something? I try to take a more cheerful tone with her. No need to upset her. Two can play the everything's fine game.
Actually, I forgot to ask you something.
Oh? What's that?
Do you want to come with me on my trip to my house?
Whoa, that's huge. That's very big.
My mom's making dinner and I thought you might want to join us.
Well, of course I accept. Emmy punches the nurse in the arm playfully.
Not you, idiot. You were over last week. I was talking to Hsao.
Oh, how interesting. Meeting the parent. I'd love to go, Emmy. Thanks. I love the nurse. Like, by this point in the game, the nurse is, like, really awesome because, A, he's a gossip and he knows everything, but he's, like, a really helpful gossip. It's not like he just gossips for the sake of gossiping. He gossips because he really cares about Emmy a lot. And, did I say one or did I say A? I'm gonna say 2B so that I don't sound too stupid. Now I sound even dumber. Whatever. Anyway, 2, he's very quippy. I like his sense of humor. He's a funny guy. Anyway, the nurse raises an eyebrow but says nothing.
Great. I'll be in my room. Swing by after you shower and change into something clean, and we'll grab the bus.
Sounds good. I'll see you in a bit. This time, it's me who leans in for a quick kiss before darting off to my room. Damn! There we go. Get back on that horse, Sasao. What an interesting development. Maybe we're getting closer after all. Maybe Emmy's finally ready to open up a little. I think what it really was that she needed to know whether or not Hsiao was willing to back off when she needs the space, and he showed that he was. Like, he didn't put up much of a fight. Sure, he got depressed and he was down about it, but that also showed that he still cared about her, but was also willing to back off and respect her wishes and let her do her own thing, and that, like, really made an impression on her. I'm hoping that's what it was, because, like I said, I would hate for these two to end up in, like, some terrible situation where they break up for good, and I'm just left here like, no, I'm sad. But anyway, or maybe she's just being polite, and a free meal seems like a good way to apologize for last night. Great, now I can't decide whether to be excited, nervous, or depressed. I settle for a combination of all three and hop in the shower. And now I know that it's so hard for people to, like, let things like this roll off their shoulders a little bit and just, like, play it casual and wait things out. Like, especially if you're, like, in a newer budding romance like Hsiao and Emi are, I totally get where Hsiao's coming from. Excuse me, I got the burpees again. But he totally needs to just chill, bring it down a bit, and he'll be fine. I know he'll be fine. He's Hsiao. He's made it through worse things before. I don't think I like riding on buses. Actually, I think I'm pretty comfortable saying that as a fact. They sway a lot, and they smell funny, and you can feel every bump in the road. Where's this coming from, man? I mean, it's true, but I'm really not looking forward to this. Plus, Emmy's legs keep making a clanking noise that draws the attention of everyone else on the bus. Dude, if you're dating her, you're going to have to deal with that. She's in shorts again, and she's got long socks drawn up to her prosthetics so they don't look so obviously false again. But that doesn't stop the odd look or two every time her legs bump together with an audible clunk. I shift nervously in my seat, and Emi raises an eyebrow questioningly. She doesn't seem to mind the stares. Either that, or she doesn't even notice that people are staring. I'm sure she's gotten her fill of odd looks before. After a certain amount of time, I doubt she'd notice anymore. Not that she'd ever tell me if I asked. Another fact is, I'm not just uncomfortable about the bus. I can't seem to come to terms with the fact that Emi appears to be trying to bring me closer while at the same time pushing me away. The nurse said she trusts me, even if it doesn't look like it. But I'm not sure I can trust the nurse. He's protective of Emi, just like I'm protective of Emi. And I'd like to say something to make her look good if someone asked me about her. So, he might just be doing that. Still, there was something about the way he seemed genuinely surprised that Emi invited me along. Maybe last night's talk helped more than I think, but I'm still worried. Meeting the parents is a big deal, right? Not that I haven't already met Emmy's mother, but that was just an acquaintance. Now it's going to be as Emmy's boyfriend, with everything that implies. I can feel my heart pounding in my chest, an echo of that snow-covered afternoon that feels like it was so long ago that it might as well be another life entirely. Except then, I didn't know what was going on. I also didn't have medication to help prevent things spiraling out of control. I've come a long way in terms of my physical health, and for the second time today, I feel like I'll be able to live normally now, or at least as normally as possible. Now, if only I could manage my relationship as well as I managed my heart, I'd be in great shape. Man, we get stuck in Hsiao's head a lot.
Well, we're here.
Emi grabs my hand as soon as we've stepped off the bus. She starts heading down the street almost immediately.
Come on, we've got a couple blocks until my place.
What? Oh, okay. I follow Emi down the street, watching her confident stride. She's setting kind of a quick pace for just a walk. I guess she's anxious to get there. So, does your mom do this sort of thing often?
Nah, not too frequently. Mom's never been much for playing hostess.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, my dad was always the one pushing her to have people over.
This sudden and unprompted reference to her father catches me off guard. And from the look on Emmy's face, I'm not sure she meant to mention him. I think I've only ever heard her talk about him once. See, her, like, unwittingly talking about things that, like, cause her pain or just, like, opening up about them, that's a good sign. That means that she's so comfortable around Hsiao that she's willing to do those things. So that is a good sign. Hopefully it continues along that path. All I remember is that Emmy's mom told me that he wasn't around anymore. Oh, your mom prefers solitude? Yeah, see, that was the hint that Emmy's mom gave to Hsiao. Oh, yeah, the dad's not around anymore. Obviously he's dead. He died in that crash. Ugh, God, Hsiao, you're thick. Emi laughs, either from relief that I didn't ask about her father or from finding my statement actually funny.
Not at all. She's why I'm such an outgoing person, you know?
Either that or, like, the other thing is, like, Emmy's father left after she lost her legs and the ability to run because, like, maybe he was one of those weird sports parents who's like, oh, sports is the only reason my kid has self-worth and, like, or I have self-worth. And then as soon as she got hurt, he was like, peace, guys, I'm gonna go find a new family or just be on my own and be creepy, whatever jerks like that do. But anyway.
She just prefers to be a guest rather than a hostess. It's less stressful that way, or so she says.
Clearly, she's never had to meet her girlfriend's mother for dinner. Emmy giggles again and speaks in a teasing tone.
Nervous as hell? You shouldn't be, you know. It's not that big a deal. Just dinner at my house, that's all.
Yeah, but have you ever brought home a boyfriend before? I confess that part of me dreads hearing the answer to this. I know very little of Emmy's past relationships. I don't even know if there were past relationships.
No, I guess I haven't. Hey, maybe this really is kind of a big deal after all.
Oh, good. Now I feel twice as nervous. Though, to tell the truth, I'm pretty happy to hear that I'm the first one. And actually, guys, I'm going to end the episode on that note before we go and we meet Emmy's mom formally. A lot happened in this episode. It got really complicated very quickly as far as emotionally between these two. But it's progress, and I'm still really, really invested. I'm glad that we haven't screwed up to the point where, like, you know, we can't play the game anymore because we made all the wrong decisions or anything like that. This path is really long, it feels like, but we're going to continue to forge ahead. We're going to beat this sometime soon, I feel like. And in the meantime, I hope that you guys are really enjoying the series. If you did enjoy this video, please be sure to hit the like button, share the video, and favorite it. Also, be sure to subscribe to me if you guys haven't already. For those of you who have, thank you so much for all of your support. You guys are the best in the world. I love every single one of you, and as always, it was great seeing you. Bye-bye.